Hello everyone and welcome to The Joy of Painting. Today we are using this beautiful blank white canvas to create a beautiful mountain landscape. But before we start, we must remember, there are no mistakes, only happy little accidents. So first we're going to start with this blue color. We're going to create a river.
The sun's smile widens and its shine brightens. The wind is subdued to a gentle kiss, and the clouds lay upon me a cool mist. The trees begin to dance with passionate desire around a vibrant scarlet fire. Beneath them, the deer gracefully prance around with gentle care and respect for the ground. The leaves release themselves from their caretakers and float through the air, glorifying their maker. A free chill races down my spine, and all my connected thoughts and emotions are aligned. I see myself as a revived being, and I feel unnatural emptiness fleeing. I take a sip of yerba mate to quench my thirst, and I understand my place in the universe. Yerba mate, now available in 20 amazing flavors.
All right, so, you know, we have a situation here and we've narrowed things down to this one suspect. Megan Irwin. Yes, Megan. I want you all to be on very high alert for passing of these products, especially Advil. You can't have that on campus. So watch out for this young lady right here.
That's Megan Irwin, right?
Prime suspect.
I've never taught this person in class, but she's always very kind.
Bro, let me just cut you off right there. Let me tell you. She is not who she seems to be at all. She is one of the most devious individuals I have ever met in my entire life.
Devious.
Ever since the time I've known her in middle school softball, it has been nothing but a disaster.
Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well.
I'm not gonna lie, It's been pretty hard to bust these punks. They're getting pretty creative at outmaneuvering us.
Hey!
My name is Michael Bowes, and I'm addicted to dabbing. The problem started around 2016 when Cam Newton made it famous. I've had problems going out in public.
The worst part is, the song doesn't even have to be lit for him to do it. I've seen him dab to Shawn Mendes. I think I've even seen him do it once to the sound of a microwave going off.
Honestly, it's just been really hard to be friends with him. His addiction keeps getting worse, and if he doesn't get help, I don't know what he's going to do in college.
I just want this to end. What is this?
Michael, we need to talk.
Hi, I'm Erica Fager.
And I'm Davis Swan.
And this is Covenant News Network.
Thank you so much for joining us today. We have quite a few stories to cover, but first, we have a very special segment to honor this very special day.
Yes, today is the 1 year anniversary since our president, Cameron Collins, won the election to become student body president. Today, we're going to look back at his campaign, and to lead us through this journey to his presidency, we have our political correspondents, Kate and Sarah Kate. Take it away, guys.
Thank you, Erica and Davis. That is correct. Today marks the 1 year anniversary of the inauguration of our president, Cameron Collins.
Now let's take a quick look back at the past year in the life of our president, Cameron Collins.
Young man, I have a quick question for you.
Oh my gosh.
What is your favorite attribute of our president, Cameron Collins?
His steadfastness.
It's beautiful.
So Holly, what do you think about Cameron Collins, our president?
Cameron Collins. Well, I mean, we all know he's the main reason behind global warming, and the die-offs of the woolly mammoths, and the massive rate of extinction of the whales, and I mean, he doesn't care about anything I care about. Like the other day, in Euro, I was talking about my favorite physicist, and he had got halfway through my spiel on my physicist, and he was just like, hold on, why do you like someone who killed millions of people? And I'm just like, did you listen to anything I said about Edward Teller? So, he's just the worst, he doesn't care about your physicists or anything.
And young lady, what do you think about our president, Cameron Collins?
Who's Cameron Collins?
Thank you. Young man, what do you think about our president, Cameron Collins?
Excuse me?
I made a huge mistake. I'm so sorry. As a supportive first lady, what do you think of our president, Cameron Collins? He's a great president. Seems honest.
And sir, what do you think about our president, Cameron Collins?
Mr. Cameron Collins, Mr. President? Collins.
As you can see, our student body has varying opinions on our current student body president. But those opinions are subject to change soon as his term is coming to an end.
I can't imagine who's going to fill these shoes, but that's for another time. Back to you, Davis and Erica.
Thank you so much, Sarah Kate and Kate, for that insightful look back at Cameron's reign as president. That was truly enlightening, don't you think, Davis?
Oh, yes, I agree. Totally.
Cameron's presidency has been one to remember for the ages. And now, onto some rather disconcerting news. Rob Sharp, beloved math teacher, also known as the Shaft, has decided to hike the Appalachian Trails due to the fact that he is a trail master. He has been missing for the past 2 weeks, and he has made no contact with family or friends, except for the fact that he did post a picture on the Instagram about 2 days ago. Thankfully, during his leave of absence, Elizabeth Bryan, the math whiz, has taken on his duties. And now, to our sports correspondents with a very important update on our CDS varsity basketball team.
Thank you, Davis and Erica. I'm here with Connor Patterson, the last remaining healthy basketball player on the team this season, and he has just injured his pinky. Connor, thoughts about the injury?
Well, this is unfortunate, of course. Being the last healthy player on the team is rough, but as a season as a whole, it's been rough, plagued by injuries left and right, mostly fake injuries. For instance, this one kid named Josh Davey, he hurt his ankle beginning of the season. Pretty sure he just wanted to see trainer Hannah. Unfortunate. Another kid, Cole Bertram, he wanted to DJ the Craze more than play basketball, so that's why we lost by 40 that game. And this other kid, he hurt his back beginning of the season, and he has not stopped talking about it the whole year. He had surgery or something 2 weeks out of school. I don't care. It's been so long. But, I mean, besides the injuries, I feel confident in the new player's ability to come in and turn the season around and maybe get another win. So.
All right. Thank you, Connor. Uh-huh. Mr. Hendrick, can I ask you a couple questions?
All right.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about some of the other players on the team?
I feel some emotions about them.
Okay. How do you feel about being pulled up to play with some of the players to fill in for some injuries?
Yeah, that's pretty exciting. I'm pretty confident that we're going to really step it up and fill our roles.
Okay. Can you tell us about some of your childhood, your career, where the upbringing came from?
My parents raised me from a young age, and as I grew up, I got better at everything.
Including basketball?
Of course.
Okay. And are there any ways you can implement calculus into your game?
I could. I've thought about that. In fact, I even have a nice image up here on the board of how to play basketball. I'm not really sure where the calculus is going to come in, but I'm going to figure it out and implement it into the game.
All right. Thank you. Back to you.
Erica, I swear if you do one more pun, I'm going to lose it.
Davis, I don't want to hear it. And I'm not the one who has to have my eyeshadow redone after every freaking take.
I need to look good for the camera, okay? I need to look good for the camera.
Guys, we're live. Now to Brooke for a quick weather update.
And now for a quick weather update. We are seeing both record highs and lows in the high school building today. The low being around 25 degrees and the high around 98 degrees with a middle ground of 69. The weather is forecasted to be partly cloudy with occasional Arctic winds in a few select classrooms. You know the ones. So pack both your Bermuda shorts and your fur coat because there's quite literally no saying what temperatures you may encounter throughout the day. And now back to you.
Thanks, Brooke, for that weather update.
Hold up. Breaking news. Pete's going to Auburn?
In a rather recent debacle, Mr. Jameson was found wandering the Carmel Christian School campus looking for his next class that he needed to teach. When asked about this strange confusion, Mr. Jameson responded with, "This new schedule is terrible and it makes it impossible for me to know where I am teaching my next class." Well, we know it's definitely not at Carmel Christian, bud.
To bring another sports news, come-to-day school student Sophie Lindner has not only broken all the female swim records, but has now broken all the male records as well. This happened at States when she competed unconventionally in both the male and female events and won every single one of them. And here, via video conference, we have Mr. Dennison, who is incredibly passionate about talking on the topic of Sophie and her incredible accomplishments.
Now, Mr. Dennison, please, tell us more about the topic of Sophie.
Well, thank you guys for having me. I don't really know why you're having me, but I'm honored to be here nonetheless. Sophie, you know, she just has really accomplished so much at such a young age. I just think it's so important to see the way that she climbed the rabbit, to see the magician. She climbed the hat out of the hat, looked the magician in the eyes. And that is what makes her a philosopher. That is what separates her from the Joannas. She is a Sophie. She perceives herself. Garter writes her in such a way that makes her perceive herself as having free will. But from a Christian perspective, we see the spiritual influence, the fundamental understanding of how Sophie interacts with the spiritual realm. And in this way, she is a Christ figure through the way that she is apart from her world and is set apart from the Joannas.
Thank you, Mr. Dennison, for that incredibly unnecessary and irrelevant commentary. And your hair looks great, by the way. Now to some other more important matters. It was reported just yesterday that the Kennedy robot was stuck in the elevator for the entirety of spring break. This happened due to the fact that the robot has no arms and is unable to open the door once inside the elevator. Because of this, he was forced to wait until a very frightened maintenance worker happened upon the elevator to find a scared and alone Kennedy. Because of this problem, Kennedy is now armed with a life alert button, which he can push to avoid any kind of mishaps such as this. And now for a special behind-the-scenes look at what really goes on during the baseball season.
Our investigative reporters, Elizabeth Bryan and Anna Haynes, are on the field now.
Literally.
Can you not do that for once in your-
Oh, God!
Thank you, Erica and Davis. We're here on Covenant Day's baseball field to investigate the baseball boys.
Yes, we're here to find out what really goes down in the dugout. Earlier, we caught up with Coach Hassan and asked him for a quick comment.
Oh, Coach Hassan, could we ask you some questions about the varsity baseball team for a second?
What's that over there?
As you can see, Coach Halston was not too keen on talking to us, so we decided to do some investigating of our own. Like, what is the deal with that very suspicious tarp?
Aha! What do we have? Oh, well,
this is not what we thought.
Oh, okay.
This is not at all
what we thought. Is that just a... Where's the Mega Fridge 2000?
Well, see, so we don't have one. All we have is an empty fridge.
We asked Covenant Day School to comment on these discoveries, but we had no reply.
So for now, the mystery continues. Back to you, Erica and Davis.
Thank you so much, Liz and Anna, for that truly riveting report. I am truly speechless.
That's a first.
Sure.
And thank you so much for joining us this evening, and have a wonderful rest of your prom.
Remember, be safe, don't be stupid, and we'll see you next week on CNN.
Don't be stupid? What kind of mind is that? Worst.
Red Bull gives you wings. 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 Gives you wings of Red Bull. Red Bull!
Birchfield.
Here.
Boyles.
Here.
Here.
Culpepper.
Here.
Dahlberg.
Here.
Fager.
Here.
Guerra. 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 Guerra.
Coming up on this season of Phase Anatomy.
I know all of you took this class so you can save lives, but only the best of you will make it.
I just took this class because I needed a science credit and didn't want to take AP.
There will be romance.
We need to talk about this. Us.
Not here, not now. I have to finish this homework. I can't have any distractions. I have to get into med school.
We are literally coloring. How will this possibly increase your chances of getting into med school?
Okay, here it is. Your choice is simple. Her or me. And I'm sure she's really great. But I love you, Derek, in a really, really big, pretend to like your taste in music, let you eat the last piece of cheesecake, hold a radio over my head outside your window, unfortunate way that makes me hate you, love you. So pick me, choose me, love me.
I'm sorry, but what's your name again, Bo? I've like never seen you around here.
There will be drama.
He's good.
Oh my God, he's already dropping. I need every stat.
This is a high school class. Why would we possibly have that?
He's flatlining.
Oh my gosh, shut up. The cat's not even real.
Okay.
Well, it ruined the fun.
Yeah, jeez.
And most importantly, there will be anatomy.
We're losing them. Charge to 350. Clear? It's a beautiful day to save lives.
This is a high school anatomy class, Sarah. What do you think we're going to be doing?
Now shut up, Sarah.
Phase Anatomy, coming this October.
Have you ever been discouraged the freshmen don't treat you with the respect that you deserve? Do you get pushed around and abused, even when you're just trying to get from place to place? You thought that once you were a senior, this wouldn't be a problem anymore. Well, we now have a solution. Introducing Freshman Repellent. With this patent-pending chemical, freshmen will be out of your way as soon as you spray. Just direct the bottle towards the nearest freshman in your path, then release. For only $18.99 for shipping and handling, you'll get an extra bottle for free. Side effects may include mad cow disease, Ebola, leprosy, flesh-eating bacteria, a positive outlook on life, diarrhea, severe anxiety, death.
Most
I can finally breathe. When I'm thank you.